Hey, what's up guys? Tyler here with Secure Team. I've got a few very interesting things to show you guys today that were discovered by my friend StreetCap1. It's been a while since I've featured some of his discoveries, and he's found a couple of very interesting things both on Mars and the Moon. So let's get to this first anomaly, as we'll call it. So StreetCap was going over some Mars rover photographs, and he discovered a very strange formation of rocks that are put together in what appears to be a very artificial way, arranged in a perfect circle, as you're seeing here. And as you're getting this close-up view here, it becomes apparent that whatever we're seeing here, it's in a perfect circle, and it's much different from the craters that we normally see on Mars and the Moon and throughout the other planets in the solar system. This almost looks like these rocks were arranged in this circular formation. Either that, or this could potentially be some sort of ruin that is a part of a much larger structure, potentially buried. But one thing's for sure, I've never seen anything quite like it on Mars. And that's why it is such a fascinating discovery. I don't think I really need to say much more about it, other than it just looks eerily out of place from the rest of the terrain, the rest of the surroundings. Now, I completely understand that on such a harsh, abstract terrain like Mars, you're going to have rocks everywhere, and you're bound to find these strange arrangements and shapes that may look artificial, but to find such an arrangement that are in such a perfect circle, that's what's really perked my interest here. So, very, very interesting. You guys let me know what you think. And while we're on the topic of strange circles on Mars, you know, this isn't the first time we have found these circular formations. Many of you may remember a video I did, I think it was about a year ago, where we found what appeared to be kind of like a Stonehenge formation on Mars, of these massive stones or boulders that looked eerily similar to the prehistoric monument of stones in Wiltshire, England, known as Stonehenge. And you know, the Stonehenge on Earth is shrouded in its own mystery. We're still trying to figure out how it was created, how these massive rocks were lifted and moved and placed on top of one another. Furthermore, the way that these rocks are angled in such a way that on the equinoxes and the solstices, the sun will be rising over the horizon and will appear to be perfectly placed between the gaps in the megaliths. And so it really has this very mysterious link with space. And so when this was discovered on Mars that looks eerily similar to the Stonehenge of Earth, of course, that made us sit up and say, okay, whoa, this is strange. We have a virtually flat terrain here where we have what has said to be what looks like an artificial mound. On top of that, these mysterious circular sets of stones. And so that opens up another can of worms, with many referring to the fact that Mars was once Earth's twin, and the fact that we have found these strange megaliths and stones on other planets and on other moons. And there seems to be a link between all of these celestial bodies in our solar system. So there have been so many instances of strange artificial structures found on Mars. There's just too many to count. And you'll have to go back in my past videos, but let me know what you think about this circular formation of rocks here. And on to another very interesting finding, again by StreetCap, of what appears to be a pyramid found in a crater on the Moon. And there's something very interesting about this particular pyramid-shaped structure, and we'll get to that here in a second. So here we are, and we're looking at an area on the Moon that is located in something called Ryder Crater. That's R-Y-D-E-R. We're looking at the high-res image, which you can find on the LROC website. I'll put the link down in the video description. And so as we zoom in here, you'll start to see this pyramid-shaped structure that looks very similar to the pyramids of Egypt, pyramids of Giza. You can see what appears to be a slightly eroded but clear four-sided structure, and you can clearly see this very well-defined corner right here facing the camera. And as you zoom in, what was also interesting is there appears to be some sort of what's been called a balcony or a foundation of something located about halfway down the pyramid, right there on the straight corner. And you can see it's casting a shadow. And try to give you the best shot here. But yeah, look at this thing. Look at this attachment that again has a very artificial straight-edged set of surface features. It just looks like an installation that's been added to this pyramid-shaped structure. So that was very interesting. And that's not the only thing in this crater that has been found in the past, because just down a ways from this structure is this object here, which we have done videos on in the past, of what is said to look like a partially buried triangular craft, sticking up out of the moon's dust, casting a shadow down below it. We'll zoom in here. And yeah, look at this thing. This thing has been featured all over the web when it was discovered. And you can see that it looks to be a very distinct, triangular-shaped, flat object that is eerily similar to the government's secret black-budget TR-3B aircraft, which you'll notice in many of the renditions that you can find, it has these very rounded corners, much like what we're seeing here. And you can see the shadow hitting the ground, so this thing is sticking up out of the moon dirt and is very close to this pyramid-shaped structure. So I definitely think that there may be something going on in this crater, and that we may have some ruins here, or, you know, some sort of ancient remnants from a cataclysm that maybe occurred on the moon. Who knows, but it's very fascinating. So kudos to StreetCap1 for his work and his eagle eye in discovering these anomalies. Whatever your thoughts, I don't think it can be denied that the study of anomalous features on the moon and on Mars is one of the most interesting and fun and addictive things to do in your spare time, if you can. We've discovered a lot of things that would tell us that these bodies in space are much more than just the cold, dead rocks that NASA and mainstream scientists would have us believe. So with that, let me know what you guys think. And before we leave today, I have some very exciting news for you guys. I am officially going to be interviewing a Mr. Dave Palaides tomorrow, Friday the 16th. Now, if you remember, Mr. Palaides is the author of the Missing 411 book series and of the brand new documentary film that was just released of the same name. And if you didn't see my recent video on this, well, basically, Mr. Palaides, who was a police officer and was in law enforcement for 20-plus years, began researching and looking into all of these mysterious disappearances that occur every single year throughout the national parks of the United States and really around the world. And when he started looking into these disappearances, he began seeing patterns and some very strange things that were occurring and surrounding these disappearances. And so he created a book series called The Missing 411, where in which he has gone into detail and listed every single missing persons case that he was able to dig up that have occurred in our national forests and national parks. And so he and I will be doing a phone interview tomorrow. And so I will have that video up later tomorrow night, if not the next day, but I should have it up the same day. So it's very exciting. If you haven't seen my video about these strange disappearances, I'll put a link to that at the end of the video as well. Do check it out. I am so psyched for this interview, and we're going to get Mr. Palaides' take on it. So be sure to stay tuned, subscribe, stick with the channel, and I will see you guys back tomorrow, where we will dive in and attempt to uncover just what is going on in our national parks. So thank you guys for stopping by today, and I will see you all back in just a bit.